Nicotinamide riboside, nicotinamide mononucleotide. Which form of niacin is best for anti-aging? Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails. Just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about which form of niacin is best for anti-aging. In the last episode, I talked about why I don't think injecting NAD intravenously is ready for prime time. So now let's talk about the different supplements that we could take. Well, it's certainly the case that nicotinamide riboside and nicotinamide mononucleotide are more likely to be beneficial than nicotinic acid or nicotinamide, also known as niacinamide, which are the forms of niacin that have been on the market the longest and are consumed the most. But then the question is, should you take NR, nicotinamide riboside, or NMN, nicotinamide mononucleotide? I would go with NR for the following reasons. There are no human studies of nicotinamide mononucleotide clearly showing how it's metabolized, unlike the fact that there are a couple of fairly short human studies with nicotinamide riboside. So we know a little bit more about it from that perspective. Then the second thing is, we have some very elegant tracer labeling studies that are done in mice where the molecules are labeled in a way that the scientists can detect exactly where they're going and in what amount and what they're doing. And we have very nice studies informing us of how nicotinamide riboside is metabolized, and we don't have the same degree of evidence for nicotinamide mononucleotide. Then the third thing is that I believe that the likelihood that NMN is absorbed intact as NMN is almost zero, whereas I believe that NR, nicotinamide riboside, is almost certainly absorbed intact, and it definitely is absorbed intact in the mouse studies that I was just referring to. The human studies also strongly suggest that it is absorbed intact, if not show it outright. The reason that I don't believe the NMN is going to be absorbed intact is because NMN has a charged phosphate on it, and in general, things with charged phosphates don't cross cellular membranes very easily. In theory, there could be a special transporter for NMN in the intestines, but it wouldn't matter for the following reasons. Because most things with charged phosphates don't cross cellular membranes very well, our intestines produce an overwhelming abundance of enzymes that have overlapping function that are not specific to any particular type of molecule and just cleave the charged phosphates off of everything in our diet. Why do they do it? Because it's way more efficient to have a handful of enzymes that are produced in very large abundance that will cleave the charged phosphates off of everything in our diet and then allow what's left over to be absorbed. It's way more efficient to do that than to have a specific transporter for transporting each of the hundreds or thousands of different specific molecules that all have their own charged phosphates on them. So the end result is that anything with a charged phosphate is going to have the charged phosphate cut off in the small intestine before it's absorbed. What happens when you cut off the charged phosphate on NMN? What do you get? Nicotinamide riboside, NR. So probably it doesn't matter whether you take NMN or you take NR because both of them will be absorbed as NR. On the other hand, we don't have studies showing that with NMN. And I also think it's possible that some people with a lot of intestinal damage might not be able to cut off the charged phosphates. And if they can't, they're probably just not going to absorb the NMN at all. So for most people, probably doesn't make a difference. For people with serious damage to their small intestine, probably better to take the NR. At the end of the day, we have more data, more studies on NR. We have more knowledge of how it's metabolized both in mice and in humans, so I'm going to go with the NR. Nicotinamide riboside is patented by ChromaDex and sold as True Niagen. This is the form that has all of the research on it, so it's the form that I would use. In the next episode, I'm going to talk about how to take it because I do have concerns both about efficacy and safety for the way that you dose it and what you take it with. So I'll cover that in the next episode. This is Chris Masterjohn of ChrisMasterjohnPhD.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.